Hey everyone, my name is Andrew Glanville, and in this video, I wanna break down a lighting setup that you guys can do at home on a budget for $120. Now, this talking head shot that you guys see so often on the internet is a very common shot that you guys need to know how to do properly. It's very common in businesses, in churches, in interviews, in YouTube. You know, it's a very common thing and it's important to know how to do it properly. So I'm gonna show you guys this setup. It's a very basic, really, lighting setup. It's just a three-point lighting setup. You guys can Google this all over the place. It's nothing new, but I'm gonna teach you guys how to do it in a very simple way that you guys can learn how to do this with the things that you already have or purchase these budget items. You don't have to purchase these exact items, but learn the principles from this video so that you guys can apply it on the things that you already have or don't have, and then you guys can purchase those things and build this setup as you guys want to. All right, so let's start with our key light here. This one cost me around $50. I bought on Amazon. If you just go on Amazon and search softbox, this was the cheapest one I could find. Cost me around $50 between the light bulb and the actual softbox. It's not very big, so it's not very soft, but I'm compensating by using a fill light. And I'm gonna explain these things in a minute. In a minute, Sarah's gonna come in the chair here, my wife Sarah, and she's gonna sit here. I'm gonna work around through the room and move some things around so you guys can see how I built this from the ground up. But let's go into the fill light. My fill light is just a 5-in-1 reflector. This cost me around $20 on Amazon. Sometimes you can find them for $15. It's a basic reflector that you just open up and close down. Very useful for other things. You can use it as diffusion, you can use it as a reflector, you can use it as negative fill even. I'll show you what negative fill is in a minute when Sarah's on the chair, but that cost me around $20. And in the back here as my hair light, I just have my LED panel, which cost me around $50 on Amazon. It's a bi-color light. That means it has two colors. It can go all the way from 5600 Kelvin all the way to 3200 Kelvin. This is 56 right now, this kind of like white light that you see, all the way down to that yellow light, which is 32 Kelvin, more of an incandescent light bulb kind of look. So that is what that is there. You guys can buy those. There's cheaper ones. I chose this one because it had a higher CRI value. I think it stands for color rendition index or something like that. That just means how accurate the color is to the number that it states to be. Anyways, let's break this down. Sarah's gonna jump into this chair. I'm gonna move some things around and show you guys how I built this from the ground up. Some things to look out for, some principles that you guys can learn in this video. And make sure to like this video, subscribe if you haven't already, and you know, do the things, put that notification bell on, maybe go into the comments and write something that you learned from this video, or maybe something that I've missed that maybe will be helpful to someone else. Let's get into it. So the first thing that I did here, you'll see that I'm determining how high I wanna get my light to be. The higher I go, the more shadows I'm introducing underneath Sarah's eyes and even underneath her chin here, to the point I got this kind of raccoon eye look that is a very unpleasant look. So as a good rule of thumb, stay at about 45 degrees up from your subject. You can also experiment with this kind of flat look, that is by putting your light basically flat in front of your subject. This is also known as beauty lighting or butterfly look. You can see it a lot in commercials or in beauty work. But we're gonna go back to more of a traditional cinema look, which is on the side, about 45 degrees and about 45 degrees up. You'll notice here that the more I rotate around Sarah, the more shadows I'm introducing on this left of Sarah's cheek. As I go all the way to the split lighting, which is 50% light and 50% shadow, you'll notice that this is a very moody look. It adds a lot of contrast to your subject. That's not exactly what we're going for right here, but I just wanted to show you guys how you can use your light. As I come around back to that 45 degree angle, you'll notice that I'm introducing that little triangle on the left of Sarah's cheek. This is also known as Rembrandt lighting. It comes from a painter that used to use this a lot in his paintings, adding little triangles on the cheeks of his subjects. This is exactly what we're looking for, so go ahead and look for that triangle while you're working on your light to get the right angle. Also, with these cheap lighting, because they're not very big, you want to get it as close as possible to your subject so that you get it as big as you can in proportion to your subject. Get it as close as you can as long as it's not in frame, and that's the best that you can do in this scenario. On a little side note here, if you guys don't have the budget for this, or you guys just don't own your lights and you still want to shoot something, just go to a window. Windows are awesome for this because they're already very large and they're introducing a lot of soft light into your house. The reason is because the sun is very high in the sky that it's not actually producing any harsh light onto you. This is why shooting on an overcast day is very pleasant. All the shadows on the faces look very nice and soft. This is what we're trying to replicate back with the lights in our house. Just remember that the bigger the light source is, the softer your light is going to be. Diffusion actually doesn't make your lights any softer. It just disperses the particles over a big surface, making the light bigger and softer. The next thing I'm going to take a look at here is my fill light. Now you can use all sorts of different things for fill light. If you don't have a 5-in-1 reflector, you can use one of these Bristol boards. You can go to the dollar store and buy these big white cards and sometimes use for homework or different projects. You can use those and just bounce the light back. And basically what we're trying to do is just fill in those shadows with a reflector or even a light. You can use LED panels or different things like that. You'll notice here that as I flip the reflector back, I'm adding negative fill. This is basically subtracting light from Sarah's face, adding more contrast or more shadow. This is because sometimes when your light is very big, it wraps around your subject in a very nice way, and you want to remove it to add a little bit of contrast. Now, since our light is very small, the reason we don't want to do this is because there's already enough shadows on the left side of Sarah's face. We actually want to bring a little bit of level back into Sarah's face so that it looks like it's a bigger light source wrapping around Sarah's face. Now we're going to be taking a look at our hair light here. Now I see a lot of people doing all sorts of different things with their hair lights or their accent lights. They like to use RGB colors or different things like that, and that's all right. I like to stay to a more of a traditional look here with more of a tungsten color. You'll notice that that tungsten color is just adding a little bit of orange on Sarah's hair or around her, separating her from the background. You'll notice that as I bring it around, it does add this nice glow around Sarah, a little bit on the rim. One thing I like to do with my hair lights is add a practical light. A practical light is just basically a light that is in your background or in your scene. The reason I like to do this is so that my hair light is being motivated by something. As you'll notice here, the dome is motivating my light for my hair light. It looks like the dome is actually casting some light onto Sarah's shoulder, whereas it's actually just my hair light. My hair light is being motivated by the dome, so I match the color to it. I also added this plant in the background to add a little bit of texture to the background so there's something nice to look at and balance out for my dome on the right side. With the same lighting setup, just by moving Sarah over to the 45 degree so that she's looking towards me, I move the light back a little bit and now I'm shooting into Sarah's shadow side. And this is a very common practice in cinema and getting this cinematic look, shooting into the shadow side. It adds more depth instead of shooting into the light side. As you'll see here, Sarah's looking towards me. It has this very nice look, and you can use this for interviews or for conversations, different things like that. All right, let's do a little recap here. So if Sarah is sitting here in the middle and we have a camera that is pointing this way, shooting into Sarah, which is right about there, then we wanna worry about three lights. One light is gonna be here. This is gonna be our biggest light, our key light. And our key light is gonna be going this way. We want to have it about 45 degrees. So here's our light at a 45 degree angle. We want to have that light pointing into Sarah. Then we want to reflect some light back into the shadows. Here's where we're going to have our reflector or your light. It's going to be reflecting some of the light that goes from here back into the shadow side, filling that in a little bit. So we have one, our key light, two, our reflector, and three over here, we're going to have our LED panel. That's gonna be shooting just right here into the rim light as our third light. And just like that, you've got your three-point lighting, you've got your key light, you've got your fill light, and you've got your rim light on the back.
Well, thanks so much for watching and sticking around to the end of this video. I hope this was helpful to you and you were able to learn something from this video. I'll see you guys on the next video.